Hamilton County is home to hundreds of historic, vacant structures, but many are in serious disrepair. Buildings such as the Mount Healthy Theater, the historic home at 4661 Hamilton in Northside, the mixed-use structure on 722 East McMillan in Walnut Hills, and Italianate structures in the West End, like 1916 Freeman, are all a vital part of our region's unique character. But sadly, many face demolition because of neglect. The Hamilton County Land Bank, a managed entity of the port, stabilizes and preserves these historical landmarks for redevelopment and reuse. Through its Historic Structure Stabilization Program, the Land Bank has stabilized 39 properties since 2014.
Port stabilization work is one of the most important things that we do. It saves Cincinnati's history, and it does it in a way that's different than anything else that Cincinnati's currently doing.
Often, the Land Bank acquires these properties after years of neglect, when they are in danger of collapse and emergency demolition. The recent collapse and necessary demolition of the Mount Auburn Cable Car Building underscores the urgency of this work. Once these structures are lost, they are gone forever.
The Port is doing great work. They have saved some wonderful buildings in different parts of the city, a lot of different neighborhoods, and without them,
The Mount Auburn Flatiron Building was named one of our region's most endangered buildings prior to its stabilization in 2018. The 1895 structure sits atop a prominent intersection, acting as an iconic landmark and gateway to the neighborhood. Stabilized in partnership with the City of Cincinnati, the building is being redeveloped by Nyer Holdings.
The port had not stabilized this building, had not chosen this building to stabilize, it would not make economic sense to redevelop this building. Port's saving of this building from demolition, and I should say, it was vacant for over 20 years before the port came in, and you can imagine how bad that building was before that stabilization. That stabilization made this project possible.
Many properties the Land Bank stabilizes don't have a buyer or development plan in place, but it's still critical to save the structure from demolition, which the port views as an irreversible solution to a temporary problem. In February of 2019, when 1916 Freeman partially collapsed in face emergency demolition, the Land Bank stepped in to save this Italianate structure in the West End. The building was in an advanced state of decay and required extensive stabilization, including rebuilding the floor plates, stairwell, roof, and front facade.
The Land Bank is an excellent partner because they've got some tools in their toolbox. They can do the expedited foreclosures, so they make an excellent partner to work with on these things to get title.
1916 Freeman does not yet have a new owner, but stabilization is the first step to getting properties like this one back to productive use. In the meantime, the Land Bank Stabilization Program continues to preserve our region's iconic structures, one building at a time.